Dad, I have a new joke for you. Why did the heating and air conditioning technician run towards the system?
I don't know. Tell me, why did the heating and air conditioning technician run towards the system?
He was charging it.
Very good. Very good. Very good.
I didn't make that one up.
Uh-huh.
All right. Hey, Dad, why is it awesome to be a heating and air conditioning technician?
Well, I tell you, one of the things I really like about our trade is, A, it's very technical. And you really kind of have to know about a lot of stuff to be a good heating and air conditioning guy. Mm-hmm. An electrician has to know about electricity. And they're, look, they're all complicated, but we have to be a mini electrician in our business. We have to be a mini plumber. We've got to know a lot of things, and a lot of our solutions can be very complicated. It's very technical. It's challenging. And I love that.
Okay. So what's another reason why it's awesome to be a technician?
It is so much fun helping people, and I can think of, I know we'll start talking about experiences or situations, I can drive through a neighborhood and go, I remember that house. It was a hot summer day. Their daughter was going to get married that weekend. It's like Friday, and their daughter's getting married this weekend. The air conditioner is out. The clan is on their way in. We're having the biggest weekend
of your life.
Of our life. It's the biggest
certainly
weekend
in
of
this
our
house.
Life.
Yeah.
And the air conditioner's out. And it was hot. Yeah. And it's like, I remember we got the air conditioner replaced and all, and it was like, I can remember walking away from there at 4:30. I think it was even later in the evening. It took into the evening. But family was showing up. Family was showing up. And they are going to have the best weekend of their life. But not without your participation in it. It's like, it would have been quite a memorable. Remember the weekend I got married and the house was hot and we couldn't do all the things we wanted to do, all that kind of thing. And when you can help somebody through a bad day, and especially when you can get them through it and it's not as bad as what they thought it was going to be, or
set them at ease, and
they're just grateful, because I am so close to the heating and air conditioning business. For there to be a problem with a furnace or an air conditioner, I'm like, well, that's not a problem. No problem. Yeah. we can take care of that. But it's so easy. I've always tried to stay grounded to the fact that most people don't know what I know about their furnace and air conditioner. So
it's
when
a
it's
catastrophe
not,
in somebody else's
it
life.
Is a catastrophe. Yeah. I have no idea what's going on or what could possibly be wrong. And how stressful that can be, and how it's just great to be able to help people get normal back. They get normal back in their life.
What was your favorite type of call to go on?
I always like those calls where, not that I would always like a call where somebody else has always been, but it's always great to find a solution that no one else has been able to find. Maybe they've had a recurring problem, or they might have had someone there and someone has told them, this needs to be replaced, or this is your problem. And you kind of find out that, no, that's not the problem. We can fix that, and I'm kind of a fix it kind of guy. It's great fun to see the relief on people's faces where you actually can fix things.
So it's awesome to be a heating and air conditioning technician because of the breadth of knowledge that it takes to be a great one. It kind of is an interesting thing to do. And two, genuinely helping people when they're probably having a bad day.
Have fun at it too. You got to have fun.
Yes.
Have fun at work.
Have fun at work. All right. Well, thanks, Dad.
Very good. Have fun.